Hello there, everyone, and welcome to something I've been meaning to do for a while, but never got around to. Perhaps I should add the sound just a bit more. Honestly, that's about as slow as I can make it. Also, why is there a line in the emulator? I don't understand. There's just a line in the emulator. But anyway, welcome to Legend of Mana. Huzzah. Oh boy, I haven't done... Well, I've tried doing this several times, but I haven't actually fully done the game in I don't know how many years now. A while. Let's go with a while. But yeah. Also, probably not the best idea for me to be recording this now because of, well, matters in June. Then again, this probably won't even get up until who knows when Stonia Fan finish uploading another series and half another series before I even get around to this one. But, might as well get recording anyway. Anyway, I will be using a guide for this. Mostly just for the map placement and the event order, because, well... This game... Honestly, it's a lot more complicated than it seems, because it doesn't really tell you enough about what... About stuff, let's just say. There's a lot to it that just isn't very explained. Which is why we have the internet. Yay for the internet. Anyway. Okay, so. New game. We can either be male with a silly hat, or female with... I don't even know what those are in their hell. The male or female, basically. Now then, here's the thing. Oh boy, oh, there are quite a few weapons to choose from. I mean, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Wait. Happy laughing. We have knife, sword, axes, two-handed sword, two-handed axe, hammers. Here's the thing. They don't actually tell you that basically these weapons all influence your stats on how you level up and all of that. That's not explained. But apparently... Yeah, there's a whole bunch of number porn just for figuring out all the stuff. I would say sword's probably one of the best weapons to go with because, well, it gives you the most balanced stats and all that. But screw that, I'm going two-handed sword. Just because I like two-handed swords. I know my name is not you. Can I go lowercase? Yes, I can. You all know it. The one and only balls. Huzzah! Now then, take note of it. This here is the world map. They want you to select a play area. Now then, you can select it pretty much anywhere you want to. Like here, well, maybe not here. But here, there. But but yeah. Thing about that is, well, let me just resort to my guide hill. See exactly where I want to place this. See about... it's like about there as well. I want to actually place this. Let me just make sure. Yeah, it's there. Yeah. Hopefully it's right. Yes, there. Confirm and all that. Okay, so here's how things work. Yeah, place the mailbot on the map. Let me close that so I can see what I'm doing. Okay, so there is also a certain order to placing all these things for maximum efficiency. Why am I making quotation marks when no one can see me? Okay. Once again, we refer to the guide. Okay. So, we want to place it basically in the middle at the very bottom. So, let's see now. 1, 2, 3. 1. Wait, do we? No, not the very middle, because there's... it's confusing. It'll get a bit simplified later on, but we want to place the mailbots here. It all makes sense eventually, hopefully. Probably not. A lot of it won't. But yeah. Now then, the Legend of Mana. And music that is potentially copyright. Also, never mind the line in the video. I don't know how to fix that. Yeah. And there you go. But that's not all. Nine centuries ago, the Mana Tree burned to ashes. The power of mana lived on inside mana stones, enchanted instruments, and artifacts. Sages fought with each other for control of these last remnants of mana. I don't think I can skip any of this. I have to actually press it to continue anyway. Okay. Then after hundreds of years of war, as the power of mana began to wane, those who saw it grew scarce, and the world returned to peace. After that, mankind grew afraid to desire, their hearts filled with empty emotions, and grew estranged from my hands. They turned their eyes away from my infinite power, and were troubled by their petty disputes. Remember me. Need me. I can provide you with everything. I am love. Find me and walk beside me. And colors. Colors. This game has lots of colors. There we go. The actual game. That's if I can remember how to do this. Okay, that's my run button. Those do. I was going to say those aren't doing anything, but yeah. Status. Or strength, HP, scale, spirit, charm, defense. All those, of course, affected by leveling up. Technically affected by which weapon we have while leveling up. Armor. There's a lot to go through. This right here will be more complicated later. Oh boy. Estes and magic and all sorts of things. I honestly don't really use magic that much in this game. Items, weapons, there's a lot of stuff to go over. Instruments, armor, artifacts. Artifacts are basically like your mailbots. They'll basically places you can go to sum it up. Diary, which is this if you fancy vault. Configurations, change the sound. Buttons. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so, first things first. This is here's the list of events. Moment's not very relevant, but it will be. As we talk to the cactus. Talk to him. We have nothing to really tell him at the moment. But we will. We will. All in good time. So we're here. Got some money for our initial stuff. And here is books, I think. Yeah. Books on characters. We don't know anyone. Well, we know the little cactus anyway. Shy little cactus. He is a cactus with a few words, but he happens to be thinking about many things. There you go. Source of land, which at the moment we only have home. Artifacts, which would be the mailbots, monsters, tenants. Basically, glossary of everything. Not really relevant, it's just there for reasons. Okay, so, technically as much as I want to actually explore the game, we... I have to actually follow this guide because, well, if I get off to... far off it, I'll end up with issues, let's just say. This is the monster spawn. It becomes relevant later. This is the workshops. Also becomes relevant later. This is back here. Becomes relevant later. This is the orchard. Becomes relevant later. A lot of things become relevant later. Let's just go with that. But now we want to go talk to this thing. Also, the problem with this thing is I can't really just change the sound. There's no fair sound option for the emulator. I have to go down to my sound settings. Change the volume. The only problem though is it's down to 1. So yeah, I can't really lower it any lower than that now. So hopefully it's fine for the recording purposes. So anyway.
I'm a sproutling. The world can be shaped by your imagination. Did you know that?
Yes. Sure, why not?
Here you go.
And you get... AF stands for artifact, so you get color blocks.
This is the town of Domina.
So it is, so it is. Now then. Let's see. I have to figure out where I have to place the bloody thing. Okay, so, edge through the world map.
Yeah, we know how to do this next game though. So we want to place this according to some map I have here, directly above said house. So basically right here. And through the power of magic. We have created Domina. Now we want to go to Domina. Also, never mind the things in the top left. They become relevant later. Everyone always plays Secret Mana, or hell, even the Japanese one that had to have be fan translated. Not many people actually play Legend of Mana, at least that I know. But yeah, I actually prefer Legend of Mana over Secret Mana. The only problem is this game is a lot more complicated. I mean, holy shit, is it complicated. Once we get into instruments and tempering weapons and all that stuff and monster ranching and there's a lot to go over. But for the moment now, we can just focus on this quest. Hey.
At least give me your name.
... He lands you.
Jeez. He makes me sick.
So yeah. Much as I want to actually explore and talk to people and all that, I don't really have the luxury, let's just say. We have to do things in a certain order.
Yay.
Okay, so I have to head uphill. This is the marketplace. I think we can actually talk to some people. Like, have light sprouting and all that.
Everyone with a soul always disappears. We don't all have souls, so we always stay. The poet Pokalel said so.
Okay.
before we talk to the rabbit thing, want your fortune told? No. Oh, okay. That probably won't come true anyway. Wise move. There's all these places. Not sure if I can even explore half these ones. I don't think I can. Maybe that one. But anyway, talk to Niccolo. My name's Niccolo. I'm a traveling merchant. But the highway is full of bandits. It's too dangerous to leave the town, don't you think so? No. How brave of you. I can't do business with those highwaymen about. Let's go teach those bandits a lesson. Once we're done, I'll make you rich. Well, I do like the sound of being rich. Quite a mercenary. I like people who know the value of money. And I'm not gonna try to do too many voices. I learned my lesson after Danganronpa. So I need to stop and see Teepo. Come with me. So now then, we go downhill. Go to speak to the Sproutling. There are many of us, but we are all one. I hate Sproutlings. Many people do. They're just weird things that speak in weirdness. Let's go with that. Anyway, in Mark's room. An adventure, eh? You should at least get some bronze gloves at the shop. Don't forget to equip them. Hit the start button to make your preparations. I thought getting Rachel a job would help cheer her up, but now I hardly get to see her anymore. Oh yeah, let me give you this book about weapons, armor, and instruments. Look over in your study and feel free to check out our shop. So now then we have equipment encyclopedia. And this here's Teepo. Oh god, I've used my British accent. Why, it's Niccolo. Hello, Gov. How have you been? Have you got anything good for me today? That's not British. That's just bad. Actually, I have a splendid item today, but I just can't let it go. Oi, Niccolo. You just time to round me up? It's just junk anyway. Quiet, Onion. This is it. It's a wheel I picked up on the highway. It looks like a regular old wheel to me. My god, I made it more Scottish than... let's just try... Roll with it. Fine, I'm going. You're right. This is just an old wheel. And if it's spatial... Hang on there, Gov. I can tell it ain't no regular wheel. I'll take it. How much do you want for it? 50,000 lucre. Niccolo. You're way too proud for your own good. Never costs that much. It's the truth. Okay, well, bring me 50,000 lucre. Until then, I'll let Balls use it. And we get the artifact wheel. Niccolo, you're the bleeding worst. I got the money, so please let me have it. I'll be back. Bloody Artless. And that's we gain the wheel. We need the wheel to basically go where we need to actually go. Also, buy items. We could buy basically any of the weapons we need. Daniel did recommend we buy, what was it? Was it the gloves or the gauntlet? Probably the gauntlet. We actually buy the gauntlet and boots, though. We might as well. Also, we don't have to really worry about encrypting our partners, because they're just NPCs. They won't actually be in our party all the time. They vary. But yeah, now we're decently equipped. Like, for example, we can actually check Niccolo's stats. He's equipped with a salesman glove, merchant's cap, traveler's garb, and boots. He's actually better equipped than us. But oh well. Such is life. So anyway, let's see. We did that. I have to actually check where to put the frickin' wheel. Okay, I got it. So yeah, good on you. Technically, you can take two crests at the town. Nicholas' crest and Elizur's crest. But you usually want to start with Nicholas. If you're trying to do this, all events and all this nonsense that I'm trying to do. Oh yeah, I forgot what the hell is I need to actually check what the save state button is. F12. Ah, it is. No, that just changes the slots. I want back to one. Did I get right? I think I did. Yeah, okay. So F1 saves, F2 changes thoughts, F3 loads. Okay. Well, try an error. Now we want to head to the highway. I want to get annoying the things in the upper right for now. Also annoying the things in the upper left. And the things down there. There's a lot of things on the map that aren't relevant yet. But for now, we want to head to the highway. So this here's the highway. Or to Onion Knight. Let's see. You're the strange white man down there. Your name's, Chumpy, right? No. Okay, well, that doesn't matter. But let me tell you things to help you in your battles. What do you want to know? So basically, tutorial. Now then, for that to get proper. Things appeal. I've been stuck a lot. Wonderful. Yes. We're going to actually do a lot of this off camera. Basically, what I like to do is once we just barely start the game, I like unlocking the majority of my abilities and STs. Which, for the most part, basically requires me to go over an entire list of things. And then go down here to our abilities. For example, we want defend. Push. Okay, so defend and push. So we basically spam the hell out of the ability and hope we unlock a new ability. Simple as that. It might take a while. There we go. Yay for controller noises.
So he could basically throw things, well, somewhat better if I could toss it properly. Instead of on top of myself. Oh, so that's lightning kick. That was a bit overkill. I forgot the actual trigger to this thing, but basically use your abilities a lot. That's why I'm doing a lot of the grinding beforehand. Actually unlocked it. Clear forevers are actually useful. But yeah, basically we can keep doing this as long as we want. Okay. No. Sometimes the abilities are hard to trigger. There we go. Certainly I haven't unlocked it yet. This is gonna be long, isn't it? So basically, yeah, love spamming buttons. Lightning kits are nice, but oh well. If you want to use it, he can use it. It's not like I have very in control of the AI. There we go. Master ability counter attack. Yeah, that was not the ability I was trying to do. That's because I was using defense. I'm trying to get grab, or just defend and push. Oh well. I mean, see, I'm using it. It's just. See? Definitely using it at times. It's just, yeah. Oh, she buggered off. Well, that's unfortunate. She is actually, the cat girl is actually Ralph Ann. A later quest. Well, technically. I'll be doing trying to do every event, just following the order of my guide. Which means ignoring a lot of stuff to do such problem. It'd be nice if I actually said I mastered the ability I'm trying to get, though. I'll do this for at least one more screen. Then I'll probably cut to do all this off camera. I should probably show that off though before we run out of enemies. Hey, there we go, finally. Okay, so. STs or spatial techniques or things like this. They usually wreck most things. They're good for bosses. And then,
getting our grapple working actually decently well.
So now then. Now I probably gonna be doing this for several hours, so in return I should have probably all my abilities and at least most of the two and sword abilities unlocked. So yeah, when we return. Still working on it. God, work on them somersaults. Look at them go. And of course I didn't get it. Why would I get it on the first 1,000? Because the game hates me. Oh no, they're still unlocking me. Oops. Somersaults. There we go, we mastered two special techniques, but we didn't learn how to somersault. Also, I should probably show off. What was it? Wind slash. It's effective. More somersaults. Somersaults. And we still haven't learned how to summon, so... fun times. Honestly, abilities are probably the worst part of grinding. Well, until we get to the part where we actually need stuff. And we still haven't learned how to summon, so... I think it's easier to just spam the buttons, like, yay, I'm jumping. Yay, I'm running. Somersault. Well, let's see if I can. I guess I do want that one. And this one, sure. I can't remember these buttons. Nope, I pressed Wind Slasher again. joy. Oh. Candies or, well, like Secret Man. They hear you. We learned defensive lunge. Let me look at defensive lunge. Defend and lunge. We're not even using defend and lunge. We're using lunge and jump to learn somersault game. Well, Niccolo's just being a badass, so good for him. Well, I'm still trying to touch some, so. Egg. At least I can show off abilities at times. Prefer getting all this out of the way before actually doing the game. And we still have a Ledger for some bloody reason. Okay, well, let's try the Legendar. Well, of course it was effective. Somersaults and jumps and lunges and more, but still enough. Jeez, game. Why did I decide to start recording again? Hey, look at that. Jump, 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 lunge, lunge, somersault, somersault. Ow. Finally. Half the failure on me just trying to learn things. Bah. Still going with this madness. Working on evade now, because evade's always fun. As you can see, dodge. We can lunge, we can retreat. Or we can bind them. I can teleport to a random location. Because evasion. It's also taking forever, of course. All these skills are. I figure I might as well show off some of the things I'm learning well. Going through this whole process. Okay, now then. Imported. It's decent, but it does crap damage. We'll be getting some really fun abilities eventually. Eventually, once I'm done with this madness. Now, finally getting down to the last of the abilities. So now then, we can flip kick. Which, honestly, it's about the same as just back flipping and attacking at the same time. But we gain his ability, so oh well. If I gain any new STs in the meantime. Not really. Also some of the abilities are the same for other abilities, like Pamela. Two-handed axe. Yeah, might as well try a scar split. It's not bad, after all. But yeah, we can flip these things. Which isn't bad. I should say, these abilities are just, of course, take forever to learn. There's some weird method where basically it's depends on how many times it counts for crouching and jumping and all sorts of things. I'm not even sure if I actually even need to spam these abilities. I don't exactly know how the algorithms work. My favorite try right now. Besides, I'm learning them. Ooh, Splash Blade. But anyway, let's try out the, what was it, this one? Yeah, Scott Smith. Yeah, Kit Rat. There we go. Now we've learnt basically every ability. So we're mostly done. Mostly done, he says. My problem though is now I have to learn the remainder of the two-end sword special techniques, which require abilities too. Okay, well, let's try learning one. Let's see, what was it? Toss and double jump. Okay, I can do that. Once I find double jump again. Also, might as well show off, what is it? Splash point? Yeah. Progress. Slow but sure. So now I can toss. If I can actually hit the enemy. Toss. Stab. These ones, I think, are more. Well, how we just learned right there. Yeah. Click on screen. Okay, so. And then, showing off these abilities once I get enough points. Which is easy enough, and just murder things left and right, which I've been doing. And he's probably gonna hit the lightning kit. No, he's not. Okay, so Splash Blade. Well, it's pretty anyway. I'm not sure if I can. Well, I guess I can. I have to change my abilities yet again. I love changing abilities and learning stuff and all that. Let's see, this one's what? Tree and taunt. Yeah. This is probably going to end up being over an hour. Mostly of me just doing this. Because we're learning stuff as we murder everything. And yeah, well, at least the spatial techniques are going a lot faster than the abilities were. Well, until we get to the final one, so that was a little difficult. How should we level up again? Yay. Because the final abilities basically require like four of the abilities that you can only have two at a time, so yeah. The math there was a bit wonky to say the least. And let's try out Rain of Blood. Well, that's definitely Rain of Blood. How's that? So now then, more techniques to learn. Forever and ever. Now then, bring it on. Well, that worked. I was like, did it even work? I was like, even gave me power up. What's a moon salt? Of course, we didn't learn any of the abilities. I think I meant to go level away, but oh well. Progress. Slow, but working. Moonsault. Moonsault lands basically to face your enemy, usually. Unless you basically attack at the end of it, then you're facing them. The dredging you worse when you start. Hey, Windwalker. What you get from, well, Moonsault. But I'm also trying to learn. Well, never building an eye. Which also requires lunge. So I don't know how many times I have to use it before I have to switch to lunge. Because these abilities are weird like that. But we can, however, go over here and. Well, let's see. Change them to lunge. Change Splash Belay to Windwalker. And try it out. Eventually. Let's tackle, let's lunge. Tackle, lunge. Tackle, lunge. That's a pretty dear thing. Wait, what? Ah, they removed all my special points. Silly rabbit. I need those special points. How am I gonna show off moves for foul? And that's unfortunate. Forgot the rabbit can do that. I'm sure this was entertaining to watch me lose my mind doing all this. Anyway, which one was it? Windwalker with it. Pretty, anyway. But still not our best. Thing is, I don't know. You know, skills to use to get everything. Progress. And still leveling things up. But now we have this! I don't know what that did. I think Niccolo stole my kill. Where's the game Marble Stream? More abilities. More. I probably should change my skills now that I think so, since I'm trying to level up both things. In fact, why am I trying to level up now? Well, learn, I should say. Yeah, sure, I could learn that one. So I have evade the crypt. So evade, somersault, and high jump. Yeah. Numbers that I have to learn. Don't know how many of each I need to do. That's the problem. Somersaults. Stop biting me, you turd. Now then, Marble Street, like I said. It's decently effective. I do like long range attacks. Though I think it also reduces the damage, though, usually. Most skills, anyway. Because, well, long range. Compared to short range. But, yeah. More skills. Oh goody, they're already dead. Or we're gonna show off that one ability we failed to show off. Oh. Well, never mind. Because now we unlocked triple offensive. Which is effective. Maybe we will show off the beautiful 3 thing eventually. I have to change my skills again. Okay, now that whole beautiful 3 thing. Right. Huzzah! Simple, simple. Well, down to like the last 2 abilities now, at least. So, progress. Did I miss everyone? Nope, there we go. Huzzah! I also did a bit of research, and apparently it's just battles. I don't have to spam the skills. So I have to win, like, I don't know, train battles by each skill. Down to the ones that require basically 2 abilities, then 2 other abilities, so, yeah. More battles. Well, there we go. Now I can stop using these. Let's see. Flip kick and evade. Goodbye, I almost forgot. Change that. To deep swing, which does extreme damage. I also reset this area because helps me keep track better. I need to do like, I don't know, 10 each, something like that. But anyway, deep sweat. Get wrecked. Well, one more skill to get. Now then, tis done. Let's Yeah, we basically just cast Ultima on now. And it gives all your stats for the fight. Also taking Moon Flip and Counter Strike. Because why not? Ben Nicolo's wasting his special techniques. And that rabbi blocked all four attacks. And then he says there's the last opponent who has to fight this group for now. Means I can have to go over here and save. So how long did this whole process take? Yeah, over 2 hours. Okay then. So, next time we shall finally actually progress the game. Now that we have basically all the abilities and all the specials. Basically, yeah, Raging Pain, Deep Swing, pretty much all we very need. Though I like Craig Ringer and the last ones, well, I can change it for whatever purpose I want. Or you can put magic though. Who knows? Magic's a bit more complicated though. But we'll get to that later on. As for now, huzzah! Progress. Till next time, hope you all enjoyed, and thank you all.